Hello, it's Michael from the Red Chair Diaries. How are you doing today? It's Friday the 4th of March. I like it when you go off on these rants because it's passion. I don't think it's shit disturbing. It's just you saying there's something wrong. And what I see is a theme in your comments. And I've looked at most of them anyway, or if not all of them, I don't actually remember. Maybe there's too many, but I did look at more than one, I can tell you. It is all about honesty, and that is how I've tried to live my life. That's how I lived my life. I'm not much of a liar, never have been, and not much of a person for duplicity. White lies here and there, that's about it. And that is why I'll always have people angry with me, because people would rather I feed them shit on a stick and call it pate. Now, another thing that you're talking about, I also share the view, though maybe I've relaxed a bit on it more than you have, you know, being the senior statesman on the net, it seems, is the concept that everybody has to come out just because I think that's the way it is or the way it should be. And I do get your comment about, you know, it being about honesty and standing up and being the man. And I agree with that because I've seen lives shattered with all of this duplicitous bullshit. I mean, I had somebody working with me for years. I remember a few years after I got there, making fun of gay people, knowing I was gay, saying, oh, what did G-A-Y go for? This is out there at BCIT. And I still remember, what did G-A-Y go for? Got AIDS yet? Now that was like 83, 84. Of course, I always suspected him as being gay, and eventually he had to come out. Anybody who collected Royal Dalton China, watched Coronation Street, and drove a motorcycle. And he had pants that were so tight that his little balls were screaming for help. I could hear them. Help me, get out of these pants. So his whole life was a mess because he came out at the wrong time, you see, trying to be something that he wasn't, with his two kids and his wife and all of that. So, like, we've all seen this, right? And you see it in these fucking politicians in the States more so than in Canada, since in Canada they're coming out of the closet, they're coming out of the wardrobe, aren't they? Yeah, I mean, in our government. There was something else you were talking about, though. About, you know, the expression, the man. It's not being a man. I wonder if that's just that whole concept of the man, meaning the head of the household, in many ways, is what we're talking about. The hunter and gatherer society and so on. Because many women are the man of the house when it comes to keeping things together. Keeping the money coming in, or keeping the kids disciplined, or whatever the case, you know, that case may be. I mean, I'm shocked at how many wimpy men get married, and who would ever find them attractive. It must be women who want to dominate them. I'm not quite sure. But you said something so funny, you know, when you go off on a rant and I go off on a rant, you know what I mean, like, you know, I'm not categorizing as a rant, I'm categorizing it as an emotional truth bringing or whatever. You said something funny like, that's not being a man, that's being a pussy. And, it's just funny. The juxtaposition sometimes is quite funny. But I don't find fault with your comments at all. I quite enjoy them. And I wouldn't mind if you would tell me your name, since you're what do they call them? Your handle is ToSHEAtower, so I assume it's Shea. I really like that. I think that's such a great play on words, ToSHEA. Anyway, you know, I think this also ties into your video where you were talking about, you know, you're basically doing a SWOT analysis as to why you weren't settled down or didn't have a boyfriend or whatever the case may be. It's because you care. You see, if you didn't care, it wouldn't matter to anybody. I mean, you care, it translates as being judgmental. I'm just telling you, considering I'm judging, because that's the burden I've carried all my life. Okay? So it's difficult. It's difficult to be the person who can't do anything but tell the truth because you alienate, you know, and that might be what you're doing regardless of what you think. So you know, you have to come to the conclusion that are you more comfortable with yourself and your own thoughts than you are with settling for somebody who you don't want to be with, you know, or them settling for you and you being duplicitous. So I think it's going to be, it'll be a tough road for a while, and one day there will be somebody standing there that you don't understand, or that you don't even understand where they came from and how you got to know them, and that will end up being the person. Because you cannot look for love. I know it sounds like Hallmark and it sounds like Oprah Winfrey, and that, you know, I get tired of her, but it finds its own level. It's like that fucking river, you know. Water finds its own level. It will get you sometime, and if it doesn't, I'm sorry, it's not meant to be, I guess, but you can't look for it. That's wisdom of the ages, and that's been imparted over the probably the millennia, and it's true. You can certainly find companionship, you can find sex, you can find marriage, whether you want to marry a man or a woman. You could be married 3 months. There's so many desperate people out there. That come out wrong. I hope you understand what I meant to say. But it will find you. And, you know, I think you're incredibly attractive because of, not just because I think you're actually quite good looking, but because of your viewpoints. That's what would attract me if I was in the market. It's standing up and saying, I got something to say. Anyway, I'm blathering. I've had a long day, not from work, but from shopping, which is something I very seldom do. And I'm having my red wine, and I was saving your video from this morning when I saw it until I could relax and actually take it in. Anyway, Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, and don't eat anything bigger than your head, and there's no pun intended there either. Bye.